So we decided to make today a spa day.
Best friends.
So what are you guys gonna do for this resupply?
The fast food challenge.
So for 4 days.
4 days.
You're only eating fast food.
Yes.
McDoubles.
McDoubles specifically.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Oh yeah.
Stay tuned, folks.
It's gonna be fantastic.
It's gonna be so good.
How many McDoubles?
62 McDoubles, just straight up. Straight up McDoubles. Made with love.
Is that everything?
Made with love.
Yeah.
Awesome.
62.
Yes. All right. Is this for here to go?
To go.
For here.
Thank you so much. Hey, thanks, guys. That was really fast.
Oh my God.
Thank you.
This is not going to fit my bag, and this weighs a lot.
Okay, so it is morning one of the fast food challenge, 7:15. While we're all eating breakfast, wild card. What are you eating?
I'm having the most perfect sandwich of the world. It's called a McDouble, and...
How is it?
It's so cold. It's so good.
We'll see if he can survive 4 days. So we left Port Clinton, had to do a little climb, but I have to do a little PSA because I feel that people give Rocksylvania a bad rep. So you always see the pictures of the big rock scrambles. People like saying, oh, Rocksylvania, blah, blah, blah. Although the rock scrambles are challenging, that's not what makes Pennsylvania challenging. It's the small little rocks that just cover the path for miles that kill your feet. So I want to show you just like a little tiny bit of that. Pointy, pointy, pointy. Yeah. Those big rock scrambles are the fun part of Rocksylvania that keep you going. The sharp little stones all over the trail for miles on end that really hurt. So be warned, Rocksylvania is not all big rock scrambles. It's a lot of little painful arch stabbers. I made it to the pinnacle. Oh, my pack is so heavy today. And if you look, that is the pulpit where we just were. At least I think so. But there's some pretty views out here of some farmland. No snakes today because it's overcast. As most of you know, I am from Pennsylvania. I lived here 19 years before I left, and I moved home about a year and a half before I started my trek of the AT. And I have to say, that I know it's not that fun. The rocks can suck, but I refuse, and to this very moment, I still agree that it is not as bad as everybody thinks. Because just when the rocks start really fucking up your ankles, you get a trail like this for a little bit. Not a rock in sight. So it's really not that bad. It's really not. Thank God I could say it any better. Okay, boys, how was your first day of the fast food challenge?
It was excellent.
It was fantastic.
I'm having a great time.
We're having a really
liars.
Good time.
Liars!
Liars, tell the truth!
We're hungry.
I'm hungry.
We're hungry.
So 8 wasn't enough?
No.
No, not at all, nearly no.
12 would have been the appropriate number.
15.
Oh, yeah.
But anything besides burgers.
How are your bellies feeling?
Rumbly.
Empty.
I drank a lot of water today.
I could definitely eat something other than a cheeseburger.
Yeah. We're basically just trying to figure out how to get to the fourth day as fast as possible.
As possible.
That's what we're trying to figure out.
Mm-hmm. Hey, cheers.
Bink it.
Cheers.
Bink.
Oh. Good morning. So, rain. Apparently that's all Pennsylvania is going to give us. Rain and rocks, the two R's of the shitty part of the AT. It's supposed to rain all day today, and for the next 6-7 days off and on.
Hey,
Well, PA, if you want us to hate you, you're doing a really good job of it.
I hate my home state.
I'm not recording everything you just said.
Stop! I love PA! The rocks aren't bad at all, yay!
So it's been raining, and we did knife's edge today, and the bake oven knob, and of my group, almost half of us fell and are bleeding. So it's no joke out here on the rocks when it's wet, which actually, so we were gonna stay at the shelter just before Lehigh, Palmerton. You get there, there's no camping, we're all soaking wet, and we said, fuck it. We're going to town.
Town food.
Yeah! So we all get to have a dry night. We're just waiting for our Uber to come take us to our beautiful hotel.
Cowboy train.
So the Country Inn and Suites took us in for the night. We're so excited to get out of the fucking rain.
He got in the car.
Even if he wasn't a service dog, I'd still be. Hi, Mom.
All right, so we're halfway up the climb. It's not that bad. It's a lot of climbing, but it's dry. So yeah, woohoo!
I'm gonna get there someday. Don't have to be denied. It's harder than you think to do nothing if you wanna do nothing right. You gotta slow your roll. You gotta slow your roll. It's a downshift, distressed.
I have never been more happy to say this, but we only have 2 days left in Pennsylvania, today and tomorrow. And then we will hopefully get to Delaware Water Gap tomorrow night. Get into Jersey, which is pretty exciting. I hate to say it, but Pennsylvania sucks. The rocks suck. And the rocks really suck when it's pouring rain for days on end. The craziest thing just happened. I was hiking and we have just a couple miles to our next shelter for a break. And I just had my head down, just cruising along. And I hear something, I'm thinking it's a deer, and I look up and not even 10 feet from me is a fucking humongous black bear. I mean, this thing stood at least to my chest. And it was big, and it moved slow. And then I turned and ran because I was scared because I was so close to it, maybe 15 feet at most. And when I turned to run, it turned and looked at me. And so I remembered, you don't run from a bear, so I just stood there and screamed at it. My life flashed before my eyes. This puffy face is coming back, apparently. It rained all night. I woke up to a puddle of water in my tent because it's been wet, because I can't dry it out. And now we have 20 miles to the water gap, and hoping we can push there. And get into a nice dry bed tonight. We're all a little sore, tired, exhausted, but the trail never ends. Well, it does end in Maine, but we're not there yet. We're gonna try to make the best of the day, it being a rainy, wet, humid day on the AT. Surprise, surprise. The Lord's been talking through the weather, a Sunday sermon. Okay, so this is the last day of the fast food challenge for Wildcard. We lost Icy Hot, took a zero yesterday, so he's out. But Wildcard is still going strong, so.
Okay, how many burgers do you have left?
So this is the last of burger 31. I have two burgers for 20 miles today. I didn't know that until I woke up. and I'm gonna make it last. We're going all the way to Delaware Water Gap today.
So he's been nibbling on this burger for 6 hours.
For the past 14 miles?
So we are just a few miles away from Delaware Water Gap. Whew, it's 2:15 and we pulled a 20 today. So I think we're getting zero tomorrow. Whew, our feet all hurt really, really bad. I want to say that this week has been one of the most mentally and physically challenging weeks we've had. One, because the rocks are never ending and they shred your feet. The other is because it's been raining every single day, and that also just adds to the pain of your feet. So it's just physically and mentally just, it's hard.
We're gonna get ice.
We have a very special moment. Wildcard is about to eat the last bite of his burger, thus completing the fast food challenge.
I starved myself today, just so you know.
How's that feel? Like victory?
Mediocre.
Now we're gonna go get some ice cream. I just have to say that I'm super thankful that we decided to zero in Delaware Water Gap. Pennsylvania broke us bad. So we'll hit the trail tomorrow, refreshed and iced and ready for Jersey.